to see you.
Mr. President, Al Kalin. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Yes, they another are. Tiger Cub World Series.
Go back to broadcasting again.
Mr. President, Armand Gilbert.
Hi.
It's a pleasure. Thanks for your letter.
Mr. President, Warren Spahn.
Hi.
Good to see you.
Mr. President, Larry Dover.
Good to see you.
Did you make any progress with the freedom, sir? They say your position is totally unsatisfactory, sir.
Is that process every day for you?
Every time you go out there, Simi.
Sam's here, they do.
Somebody asked Sam once, what would he do if he couldn't be on television? And Sam said, I'd go door to door. One of the drawbacks of this position is that I can't go out and see something like the nice game.
We'd love to have you on the National League side.
Home games, and then moved across town, went to another town and did the Sox games. And at that time, of course, the Cubs was the big audience, had the big audience, and the Sox were really the doldrums. And I never up in contention all the time I was broadcasting. But the Cubs were up in contention every time.
We're going to be that way this year, too.
It looks like it.
Oh, wait, early as July.
Yes, but now what is that about the team that's ahead on July 4th?
It's all a good idea, right? It's like seeing the polls. All right.
Well, I'll tell you, baseball is still a real great part of Americana.
You know, we try to mess it up once in a while, Mr. President, but it keeps surviving. It really does.
Yes.
I agree, it's number one. Every now and then we try to find a way to change it. And it's been running very well for 100 and some odd years. Little by little, we try to make an inroad and with some new, the DAs, so to speak. And I think if we just leave it alone, we can manage to survive all of it.
Yeah, we hope.
Did you find time to be our commission?
2 days a week?
I don't think that is.
No, we have one.
Peter Yorba, no, it's in the American.
Oh, my God, that's right. Yeah. Yes, I did. He's a good man.
He's a good man.
You know, the industry that I then went to, used to be in Hollywood, turned to baseball for the answer therefrom. Most people don't realize or remember that motion pictures have gotten just about as scabby as they are today, and the people of this country just rebelled. It was family entertainment. Mm-hmm. They took their kids to the movies and they said, we won't put up with it anymore. Right. And the major studios together and hired Will Hayes, mm-hmm. the baseball czar, who would come in as an answer to the Black Sox.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And he straightened out the motion picture industry. And why they'd ever let that go.
Slip back more.
Yeah. I'm not very proud of this society. But old Will Hayes, he said it. He would be the czar. What he said would go. And he set a code. And lots of times, we used to rebel a little bit that it was too restrictive. And yet, as I look back now, you know, there wasn't even a hell or a damn on the screen.
Right.
Even motion picture kisses were pretty circus. Like today, when I look at a love scene on the screen, I think they're trying to eat their way through each other.
Mr. President, I wasn't playing Grover Cleveland Alexander in the movie.
Oh, listen, that was a wonderful experience. Someone here was...
Yes, me.
Yes, right. I was a part of that, connected with that. We had a great bunch of... ball players there that were with us, but we had to hire a certain number of extras to keep them happy, to be ball players too. And it got to be wonderful. I never forget, they had this camera set up on me one day, and I was so they could get front shots of me pitching. And so I was throwing past the camera. And, Lord, what was his name? Al Lyons.
Sure.
He just put on a glove back there to catch him and toss him back in so that I could catch him, you know, and then get my sign and all. And throwing him, and I kept on throwing him, and I threw one on the wrong side of the camera. And he made a wild stab with his bare hand and caught it. And afterward, Al came up to me and he said, gee, Alex, I'm sorry I had to catch your blazer. They wanted a shot of an outfielder coming in and falling, trying to catch the ball. And so they had to use one of the extras for that. and he fell and dislocated his shoulder. And he's sitting there on the ground with a dislocated shoulder. The crowds all gathered around. And I can't remember whether it was Peanuts Lowry or who came.
He was in the show.
Yeah, he was in that. Yeah. He came elbow his way through. And again, it was Al Lyons who was the guy. And he's standing there tossing the ball and wide looking at this fellow. And Peanuts said to him, just what happened? And Al says, they're not putting the material into these days.
Lem was in the picture.
Yeah, so.
Yep, there were they. Bob Lem.
Oh, yes. He was.
Yes,
he
was.
Yeah.
Some of the pitching.
But he also reported early, and he was the guy that taught me to pitch. I thought I knew how to throw, but I discovered that pitching is an entirely different method of throwing.
It's about 8:30 in the morning, Mr. President. We're at Griffith Park. They have done some tight scenes with you. Now, Lou Feldman directed that picture, as I remember.
Yeah.
And they had the big plate lights, one by first base and one in second. Lem's left it out a little bit, and I'm going to hit. And the director asked that I hit the first pitch between the first base plate light and the second.
Oh, sir.
Now I can hear Lem go, whoo! There's no way. I'm sure it will be 3 days before they hit that.
Oh, and Metkovich.
Yeah,
I played with George.
Well, I have to tell you, he would, all day long, we're doing these scenes and everything, we didn't know this, he would learn the lines. Then we'd get on a bus, like, to go in from location after we'd been out there, like in Griffith Park or someplace, and he'd start playing the scenes over with. So finally, one day, I wanted a ball player at the plate, shot on the ball player and the umpire calls a strike and wanted Met to just really do what he'd do if he thought it wasn't a strike. Now, he's been just horsing around and so bold all the time, you know, and Lou picked him, thought he'd be the fellow that really be able to do. Said to him, just do what you do. The ump's called a strike and you're convinced it was a ball, but it wasn't. Now, there's the camera line. He's up to play. And it was all the difference in the world. Threw the ball in the umpire said, stir right. And Met. Secret in the history of baseball, and Warners wouldn't let us use the word. They were afraid of it, to use the word, because things people thought differently in those days. So all we could do was have that, in addition to his drinking, that Alex was covering up a kind of a nervous seizure or something. They wouldn't let us use the word what he actually had. Mm-hmm. He was an epileptic.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And he was so ashamed of that that in Chicago, when a judge publicly dressed him down, he was picked up in the gutter, and as a role model for kids and how ashamed he should be that he was drunk in the gutter. He wasn't drunk in the gutter. He'd had an epileptic seizure. But he would rather take that and be able to leave the other than admit it. But the biggest thing of all was when he went up to the plate and faced that man in that 1926 World Series, seventh inning, nobody out and bases loaded. He was facing the only other epileptic in baseball.
Oh, I was there.
Yes. Yeah. And Amy told us they knew it about each other.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
If I got to see you, this thing I could have to
come. Thank you. Full guy. Yeah, I got it.
Thank you.
I'm on his way in. I guess I'm in the middle. I am. Okay, let's go.